I'm Patricia Bleckman with KE2 Therm Solutions. In this video, we're going to show you how simple it is to wire a KE2 Temp plus air defrost controller to control your walk-in freezer, walk-in cooler, or other refrigeration equipment. To start, carefully remove the cover. Remember, there's a cable between the cover and the relay board. Identify the terminals at the bottom of the controller, and in your mind, number the screws from 1 to 5 from left to right. Put line 1 or L1 in the number 1 location. Put line 2 or neutral in the terminal number 2 location. This is just enough to bring the controller to life. At this point, it can now measure the temperature and monitor using the temperature sensor if that's all you need. It is not ready to control the liquid line solenoid or the compressor at this time. As you can see in the diagram, the controller power is separated from the relay power. This design was selected by our refrigeration engineers to allow you to power the controller with one voltage and the relay to control a different voltage. For example, the controller could be powered with 115 volt power and control a 24 volt liquid line solenoid coil. If your liquid line solenoid is the same voltage as your controller power, make a jumper from one position to the number 5 position. This provides power from the line 1 to the dry contact relay's common terminal. Locate the two wires from the liquid line solenoid or compressor. Take one of the wires and connect it to the terminal number 4 location. This supplies power from line 1 to the liquid line solenoid. Take the second wire and connect it in the terminal number 2 location, which is the same location as the line 2 or neutral wire. The KE2 Temp now has both power for the controller and power to control the refrigeration equipment. Your controller is now wired and ready to run your refrigeration system. One other thing to consider, if your customer is interested in monitoring and receiving notifications, the KE2 LDA, Local Area Dashboard and Alarms, can be connected to the KE2 Temp and the customer network. We also have YouTube videos on the KE2 LDA. For more information, visit our website or contact our tech support line.